नमस्कार, आज हमारे साथ मिसेस देवजानी रॉय हैं, CHRO माइंड योर फ्लीट। यंग माइंड स्टॉक शो में मैम आपका स्वागत है। वी नो यू ऑलरेडी हैव अ ह्यूज फैन फॉलोइंग फ्रॉम HR फ्रेटर्निटी, इंडस्ट्री पीपल एंड लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स ऑल्सो। सो यू आर एन ऑल टाइम फेवरेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स। सो टूडे वी वुड लाइक यू टू स्पीक समथिंग अबाउट बीटिंग एडवर्सिटी एट इट्स ओन गेम। सम मैसेज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स प्लीज।
Hi Shefali, thank you so much for having me on your talk show. I think it's wonderful that you create these platforms for us through which we are able to actually relate to and speak to people across at different segments. Yeah, you're right. I think one of the biggest earnings that I've had throughout my career has been the goodwill with people. Friends and fraternity like yourself and many others have really kept me going through so many of the years. But yes, my current favorites are of course the students with whom I've been interacting in large and wide scale across universities and colleges. So at this point of time, when there's so much of demotivation around and a certain amount of depression which is hitting most of us across segments, whether it's the corporate, whether it's the academic world, and all around because of this coronavirus pandemic, I would like to possibly share just a few words for my students. Many of them have reached out to me very despondent and very demotivated, saying that, ma'am, what's going to happen to us? Especially the current batch of students who are undergoing B school studies, their management studies, they're very, very upset because their internships, which used to happen during this time, used to define how well their placements would happen in the final years. Most of the questions in their placement interviews would hover around how good or how bad and what they had learned through their internships. And the very fact that today many of these favorite students find themselves without having internships, or because they were either withdrawn at the last moment or they've been postponed indefinitely and we don't know when that's going to happen. Many of them are very, very insecure and they've asked for answers. My answer is very simple. If the problem is around you, the solution has to come from yourself. Not all the time can you look for solutions from somebody else. However, direction is something that definitely some of us can lend. With the limited experience and knowledge that I have, I would possibly outline a couple of strategies that my dear students, you can adapt for yourself, which will help you see through this very difficult period. You have this golden moment, this golden opportunity before you, the time for about 2 months. You wouldn't have had this time under the normal circumstances because you would have been working under those stated internships in another corporate. However, now that it has been defined and God has designed in a manner that you have this time for yourself, do things which will add to your personality. At the end of the day, when you go in for your placement interviews, it's not just the academic prowess that your interviewers are going to look into you, but also what else have you done? How holistic a personality are you? And in order to do that, what can you do? A, I'm sure you're not just a linear person only involved with academics. I'm sure a lot of you have a lot of skills within you, which you may not have pursued because of the paucity of time. Someone could be very good at photography. Someone could have a creative bent of writing. Somebody could be doing a very nice painting. These are hobbies that probably you never bothered to take forward because either you didn't feel the need or you didn't feel the pressure or there was no time. But now you have the time. And with the internet and the online facilities available to you, you have lots of people coming forth, assisting you in getting enrolled into online classes for photography, for creative writing, and such things where certifications are also allowed. So who stops you from skilling yourself or adding another one or two skills to your personality, which will finally create a very different side to yourself altogether? So that's my first therapy for you. The second one would be read. One of the things that I find today's generation is lacking in is an overall comprehensive knowledge about our roots, our culture, about our wherewithals, how we started, what were the previous times like? Where are we today? Do we have a holistic understanding of what the economy, the social syndromes are all around and how can we become a part of it? We are a wonderful country. We probably boast of knowing other countries better, But I am shocked when I meet with a lot of good students. They know so much about the Western world, but when it comes to knowing your own country, I'm sorry, there's a lot amiss. We are a wonderful country with a very rich history, with a very rich cultural background. Why would you not know about it? When you go for international studies, when you meet in international seminars, when you talk about the rich heritage of your country, believe you me, and I speak from experience, they wake up and they listen to you with a lot more respect than possibly if you can parrot, you know, things that are part of their culture. So read. I think you have a golden opportunity again in front of you. Look into books which are not always factual and autobiographical, but semi-fictional also gives you a lot of information that you could be drawing upon. And last but not the least, every one of us does need a certain idol, a certain mentor for ourselves. Some of us have been lucky enough to find it in our lives, and some probably have never thought that it's an important part. Why don't you look forth and reach out to someone that you've always really admired, but you've never had the chance to really seek that kind of a guidance. You have the LinkedIn, you have all kinds of social media today available to you through which your network is proliferating. Seek out people who you think are knowledge masters. Reach out to them and ask for becoming their mentees. Ask for certain guidance. Look at what they do in their day-to-day part. Even if you were to take on some 20-30% of what those people do in their life, how they conduct themselves, let me tell you, you will be benefited far more than what you can think of today. I don't want to go into prescribing too many of things because then you'll be spreading yourself too thin. But I'm very clear that if you were to pick up any one or a multiple of these solutions that I've just, you know, sort of outlined for you in simple terms, you will be far better placed to face the interview at the end of your curriculum, and you'll probably have a placement which is better than any other. Take my word for it, go all out. Thank you, Shafal.
Wonderful, ma'am. So I believe these golden words will help a lot of students, because where a lot of people are already struggling only with how to get a summer placement, if they think differently that they can leverage this time for finding a mentor, finding some good reads for them, upskilling themselves, upgrading themselves. So that blank column in their resume, they can fill up with a lot of things. So this is, I think, a brilliant idea which a lot of people are missing. And if they watch your video, so they'll have a lot of insights for them. So thank you so much for coming live on Young Minds Talk Show. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Shivali.